Are y'all ready for the shortest video I've ever done? The top five guns everyone must own. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, just kidding, guys. Clint here with Classic Firearms, here to talk to you all about the top five guns everyone should own. And no, the Barrett M107 didn't make the list. It's on my list personally. But in case you guys didn't know, we just started a new giveaway to Barrett M107. Stay tuned to the end of this video to figure out exactly how to get your entries in. Of course, if you've been around the channel for any length of time, you already know what to do, so go do it. Only after you watch this video, of course. So let's go ahead and hop into number one, the AK variant. And I'm gonna say variant because the AK-47 is typically a select fire, full auto type of firearm, right? However, most of what you see on the market today is a semi-auto AKM, or the AK modernized. And technically what I have right here is the Zastava Arms M70. So it looks like an AK. It's gonna have some features that aren't exactly AK esque, if you will. So for instance, it's going to have a little bit longer handguard, so it's not going to be like any AK handguard that you can use with this guy. You do have to go with more of a Yugo style, which is completely fine. And ultimately, the reason we have an AK variant on the list is because these guns are realistically probably the most popular rifle in the world. Billions of units produced, still produced today, has been produced since probably 1947, if I had to guess. And the ammunition is still common and available, 7.62x39. There are different variants out there that fire different calibers. 5.45 is a great one, like the AK-74 and among other things. But this just being so common, so reliable, fun to shoot, I highly recommend that everybody familiarize themselves with one. And the best way to do that is to own one. So the AK variant, definitely on our top five list. And what do you guys think? Should everybody own an AK? Now, granted, I know a lot of people are gonna, you know, throw their politics in it and everything else like that, but you know what? Those don't matter. So what you need to do is say, heck yes, AK, or heck no, and give a reason why. Let it be a good reason. If it's politics and all that stuff, eh, we're not gonna listen to that. Anyway, let's move on to number two. Obviously, the AR-15. Now, this is America's carbine. This rifle here has been the rifle of choice for most sporters, most shooters in the United States for quite some time now. In fact, the AR-15 came before the M16, believe it or not. And let's go ahead and clear something really quick. I know a lot of you guys that have been watching us for a while that are already into firearms as a sport, as a hobby, whatever it may be. You already know that AR in AR-15 stands for Armalite Rifle, being that Armalite, that manufacturer, produced the AR-15 for the first time. What I'm holding here is a Springfield Saint, but same initial thing, right? Same style, everything else. But AR does not stand for assault rifle. Just want to throw that out there. I know there's a lot of misconception, misleading information out there. AR-15, Armalite Rifle, Model 15. 5.56, 223 caliber, very easy to shoot, very easy to learn how to shoot, and also too super common. As you guys know, the M16 is based off the AR-15 design, and it's been what the United States military has been using as their standard service rifle for decades now. And it's still what I'm issued in the Marine Reserves, and I'm a fan of it. You know, when they first came out, the AR-15 was fine, but when the M16 was first adopted by the United States military, there were some problems, right? Everybody was like, oh, look at this cheap plastic gun. It keeps jamming. It can't handle, you know, this jungle warfare that we're having in Vietnam. Let's go back to the M14 and all sorts of things back and forth. But it was still widely popular because of its lightweight design, the fact that you could fire the 5.56 223 cartridge and you could carry pretty much about twice as many rounds than you could the 7.62 NATO cartridge. 7.62 NATO being bigger, heavier, 5.56 still just as effective. Well, I'm not gonna say just as effective, but still very effective, but lighter, you could carry more of it, things along those lines. Now, the AR-15 is super popular here in the US, again, because of its design, because of its simplicity. We build them easily and, of course, legally. They're simple to put together, honestly. If you guys, and I totally recommend building your own AR-15, for one, it's a huge educational thing. You learn so much from doing it, and you kind of learn all the parts and pieces that go together. And me as an enthusiast myself, I just love the science behind firearms in general. I mean, you literally have a small explosion taking place in front of your face. It's all contained within the upper receiver. You've got gases traveling out the barrel, up through a gas block, down through a gas tube. It's all just pretty incredible if you ask me. Science, right? But anyway, AR-15 definitely on the list. Let's move on to the next one. Y'all already know. A 1911. This is the gun I grew up with. This was my dad's Colt government model, Series 70, 45 ACP, model 1911. And I absolutely love this gun. This is the first pistol I ever shot, and I'm honored to still have it in my collection. And I absolutely love a 1911 pistol. This isn't a debatable topic, everybody. I'm throwing that out there right now. This isn't a debate about whether or not the 1911 is a great gun, whether or not it's a go-to-war gun or whatever else it might be. It's hit the fan, I'm gonna grab my 1911. No, this is just about what you guys should have in your collection. Now, granted, there are several firearms out there that have a little bit more modern design, higher capacity, things like that. But as far as just shooting and appreciation of some fine equipment, you can't go wrong with a Colt 1911 or some of the very, very different manufacturers that are out there. Check out STI and the 2011. Also check out, I don't know, just about what Springfield has one, Rock Island has one, Ruger has a 1911. There's just about everybody makes a 1911, right? I'm surprised Glock hasn't started making a 1911. Yeah, right. Anyway, but it's not just the 1911. It's a hammer-fired pistol in general. So you might have your Beretta M9 sitting at home, or I don't know, an FNX 45 Tactical, some of my other favorite hammer-fired guns. But ultimately, a hammer-fired gun, I think, you know, it's just kind of the OG. When John Moses Browning pretty much came out with the model 1911, this set the design, this set the precedence for pretty much a lot of future guns to come. And it's just super cool. That's really all there is to it. And they're classy, man. I see a 1911, I'm just thinking style, right? But no, the 1911 hammer-fired pistol is definitely on the list. So what do you think the next one's gonna be? Yes, a Glock. Striker fired at that. So a striker fired pistol, absolutely. This is kind of like the modern age of pistols being striker fired, things along those lines. And I own AKs, ARs, 1911s, Glocks, among other things. And I gotta tell you, I have an appreciation for all of them. I know a lot of people out there who are maybe diehard HK fans, and they're like, I will never own a Glock. But somewhere in their safe, they're sitting a Glock 19 or whatever else. It might be I will never carry a Glock, but they definitely own one. I know you guys do. But anyway, James, where are you at? I'm looking at you. But anyway, the Glock, this is actually the Glock model 45. Don't get confused, all right? Glock likes to confuse their fan base out there. The Glock 22 is a 40 cal. the Glock 45 is a 9mm. All right, so the one that makes the most sense is probably the Glock 19, because it's at least 9x19, but just don't get confused, okay, guys? But anyway, the striker-fired system, all in all, I think is just a great platform. Everything's internal, right? There's nothing external like a hammer here. It's a striker system. Imagine like a pin. All right, like a little click pin, and it's got a spring in there, and you can see the pin. Yeah, so imagine that kind of like a striker-fired system. Pretty similar, kinda. But anyway, striker-fired systems are great. They're fun. They're easy to shoot. The safety on them, you know, you don't have to fumble with anything external. Like I said, you just have a little blade safety right forward of the trigger. So if you don't have an appropriate grip on the trigger, it's not going to go anywhere. Notice I'm just grabbing the side of the trigger and I can't pull it back. It's only once you have an appropriate and you're applying pressure on the blade, that safety and the trigger, will you be able to pull the trigger. Just like that, all right? Now, another thing that's pretty cool about some of these modern firearms, like the Glock, and I say modern, even though it's been around since the 80s, but a lot of variations have come about. I mean, how many generations of Glock perfection do you need, right? So we're on the fifth gen now, and among other things. But there's also companies out there like Shadow Systems that kind of make a Glock look a little less tactical, I guess you could say. But anyway, this right here is the Shadow Systems MR920, pretty much based off of a Glock design, right? Striker fired, very similar look and everything else. Takes even Glock magazines. But you can tell here, we've got some aggressive slide cuts. You got the RMR thrown on it, an RMR cut. You got different triggers on it, stippling all over the place. And that's what's kind of neat about a lot of firearms is the ability to customize it and make it really what you want. But this is a factory production gun, which is super cool. So straight from the factory, you're getting, you know, the the night sights, you're getting the cut, the slide cuts, you're getting the threaded and fluted barrel. Look at that. Oh yeah, it's just overall really cool. But striker fired guns are definitely on the list because of their, well, popularity, their reliability, and just overall fun to shoot. All right, add one to your collection if you don't already have one. Let's move on to the next. Last on our top five list, yep, a shotgun. You gotta buy at least, you know, just one shotgun. And this is my first shotgun purchase, Remington 870 Tactical. As you can tell, I added like the little side holster to it, but that's the only thing I've done to this gun. I love shooting it. Pump action shotguns are just a lot of fun. And I think they also serve a great purpose. They can be used in the tactical mindset. They can be used for hunting. And this one specifically, it is called the 870 Tactical Magpul Edition, so it's got the Magpul stock on it, which is super ergonomic, and also the Magpul forend, and then your little breacher muzzle device. And what's kind of cool about these is it's made to, you know, stick into a door frame, whatever it is, to blow out the hinges or the lock. And the reason you have all these ports in the muzzle device is so that all those escaping gases, they don't just, you know, blow up your gun. They have to go somewhere, especially if this is blocked. Also too, yes, it's clear. All right, just throwing it out there. Educational purposes, I'm putting my hand on the muzzle, okay? Anyway, so just so you don't have some sort of foreign object or whatever it is blocking all of those escaping gases, you have all these ports here that allow those gases to escape. That's really the only purpose, all right? But anyway, shotguns are great. A lot of people recommend them for home defense. We have a video, a few videos out there where I talk about that's probably not the most ideal thing, especially for new shooters, first time firearm owners. I wouldn't really recommend it. There's a lot more recoil, a lot more of a bang than you'd expect. Something a little bit easier to handle, handle recoil, whatever else it is, get accurate shots. A pistol would be probably even more adequate. But also too, the misconception of you don't really have to aim. You can just, you know, pop, 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 and you're all set. No, you need to aim, okay? You always need to aim. Anyway, but shotguns definitely have their place, and I have a few of them. I love shooting them. I love going skeet shooting, trap shooting. I love, I don't know, just shooting them and running drills and everything else. They're a lot of fun. So shotguns are definitely on the list, all right? And this is gonna be the conclusion of our top five list. So we've covered AR-15s, we've covered AKs, we've covered 1911s and Glocks, and of course shotguns. And you may or may not agree with this list, but I think as a top five overall basis, this covers all of the fields, I guess you could say. But anyway, I wanna hear from you guys down in the comments section below. Did we miss something? Should we do maybe a part two, another top five guns, something like that? I know a lot of you hunters out there are like, where are the bolt action guns? You're talking about classic cool and all that stuff. Where's that at? It's like, okay, I feel you, but there's a reason why bolt action guns didn't make it onto the list here. They're not simply as common as everything else we just talked about today. Now, you might be thinking that's also not true, but it kind of is. A lot of new shooters out there and everything, their first purchase isn't going to be a bolt action gun. Typically, if you disagree with me, let me know down in the comments. I'm curious to hear from you guys. But if we should do another top five, a part two top five, maybe this is only part one of our top 10, I don't know. Let me know also down in the comments because I have a whole list of other guns in my head that I would love to talk about. But of course, the last gun I'm gonna talk about is truly the number one gun everybody should own, especially if it's free. The Barrett M107. We just started this giveaway. We hung out with Alex Zedra. For those of you that don't know Alex, if you play Call of Duty, you probably know her because she is Operator Mara on Call of Duty Warzone. And we worked together, had some fun with a little friendly shooting competition against each other. Check that video out. But also too, we announced the Barrett M107 50 BMG back-to-back 50 giveaways because it's the season of giving, so why not give away 50s, right? We've also got an EOTech Voodoo scope on it. This is my first time shooting with the EOTech Voodoo, and I gotta tell you guys, it's really nice, all right? The glass on that is quite outstanding. So to hear a little bit more about this guy, see it in action, see Alex run and gun with it, go check out that video. And of course, we've got a video. She's got her own video. Check out Alex Zedra. She's a great streamer and everything else, all right? So we'll leave it off there. ClassicFirearms.com is where you can get your entries. Hit that top banner, and from there, it's gonna take you to a webpage that shows you all the different ways to get your entries, links, and all that stuff. And for this week's giveaway code word, it's quite simple, Zedra, Z-E-D-R-A, not zebra, Zedra, all right? And we'll leave it off there. God bless you guys, and we'll see you next time at ClassicFirearms.com.